So I'm here with Ivor Caplin. We're going to be talking about Brighton and Hove Albion.
Of course.
Just past the halfway point now. Are Brighton going to stay up, Ivor? Because we had a fairly good result, 3-3 on Saturday.
I'm pretty confident. I think we've been playing well all season. I think, you know, we've had some good results against some of the top six, against Arsenal away, obviously Spurs at home, the Chelsea game on New Year's Day. You know, it looks like it's better. It's congested at the bottom, of course. It always is. And, you know, some wins now in February. We've got three interesting games, Watford at home, Palace at home and Sheffield United away.
They are winnable. Yeah.
And I think that, you know, the squad is in good shape.
Yeah.
I'm really pleased with some of the you know, what's happened in January. And I think we can you know, get ourselves clear pretty quickly.
Yeah, we haven't dropped into, we've said on stage, haven't dropped into that bottom three yet, which is a good, psychologically that's important, isn't it? Because it could have, we were for a bit on Saturday, we were in the bottom three, and then obviously we got the draw, so.
Yeah, and of course we could have won. I mean, yes. In the last 10 minutes of that match, I think it's quite interesting. I think both David Moyes and Graham Potter spotted the fact that West Ham would get tired. They played Liverpool, of course, on the Wednesday, which was their game in hand. And that is exactly what happened. West Ham ran out of puff and, you know, Brighton steamrolled through and they could easily have pinched a fourth goal, which would have been incredible. And we have a great record against West Ham.
Yeah.
Six games, three wins, three draws. I mean, that's pretty unusual in Premier League circles. I think, you know, we're in a decent position, but as I say, we've got to start picking up a few wins.
Yeah, we're slightly behind on the points tally from last season, though, aren't we? So we need to have a better second half than last season, because otherwise...
Well, I think one of the things about last season is, in this last 10, 15 games, we lost our way, particularly at home. And I think in the last 9 or 10 home games last season, we only picked up 5 points, a win and two draws. We already have 5 points.
Yeah.
We've got a win against Bournemouth and then the two draws, Chelsea and Villa, at home.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, and we've also got to reflect that we've played away all the big sides.
Yes.
So, you know, that you can't always compare the seasons because different
light
fixtures,
they're
not like for like. But nevertheless, it's about our performance. And I think... you know, that we've been playing well. We've got one of the best goal differences of the bottom eight, which is really important. And I think if we can just turn those opening half hours, 45 minutes, like we saw against Villa at the Amex, you know, if we can turn those into goals, I think that will be really important. But I thought, you know, the way the team came back from being 2-0 down and 3-1 down, sometimes in a season, this is what happens to move the season on.
Yes.
Take it to the next
stage.
And it occurred to me that a few years ago, I think it may have even been in the season we went up, we were at home to Charlton and we were 2-0 down at half-time. And I remember saying to some friends, this is the most important second half we'll have. And we won 3-2.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes you need that in football. And I saw Glenn Murray talking about this. It's time to move on and to drive on. So, you know... I think Brighton fans, we can be optimistic about the second half.
I feel the same as well. I don't know why, but I actually feel the same as well. For some reason, I think Brighton will stay up. And I think that was quite a big turning point on Saturday as well. Just to come from 3-1 down away, psychologically, that's important.
Yeah, I think that's true. And look, it's a good team. It's a good squad. I mean, you know, have the benefit of bringing in McAllister, of course, who's you know, been playing brilliantly in Argentina when he's finished with the Olympic qualifying. So that adds to the squad. We didn't lose anyone during the January window. We brought in the young lad from Chelsea, who's highly thought of in England circles as well. I think these are good signings. These are young players who are hungry to play. And I think that's going to sharpen up the squad in some of those places. There's no real, you know, he's probably... with the exception probably of Matty Ryan and Lewis Dunk, there's no certainties in the squad. And I think that's good for Graham Potter.
Yeah, and just finally, so we've got prediction for Saturday, Watford at home.
Well, these are the must-win games. So, as you know, I have a legendary punditry skills stemming from 2016, where I forecasts, Remain vote followed by Hillary Clinton. So on that basis, maybe I'll not say what I think might happen on Saturday.
But we're hoping for a win, aren't we, there?
And, yes, we are, yeah. I mean, look, Watford and Palace at home are two really important games. Win those two and, you know, we'll be on our way to the 40-point mark.
All right, we'll leave it there, Ivor. Thanks for coming in. Cheers.
Pleasure.
Thanks.